My father, Willard Boyle, is quite well known because he won the Nobel Prize in 2009 for his invention of the charge couple device. But he started off his life here in this small town, this village of Wallace, Nova Scotia, on the Northumberland Strait. And after his various career paths and going through his life story, he came back and retired here. He was raised and taught by his mother, who had took a Socratic approach. She'd ask him a lot of questions, and he knew he had a lot of things he had to work on so he could answer her properly. And then when he got to middle school, he went down to Lower Canada College in Montreal, which was a dramatic change from having been brought up in a lumberjack camp. Suddenly he's living in kind of a preppy school in Montreal, but he got a very good quality education there. And he followed that up by going to McGill University, which he always spoke very highly of as an institution. And the war came in the middle of his education at McGill, and he went off and learned how to fly Spitfires. He was a Spitfire fighter. When he came back, he got a job at Lower Canada College in Kingston, where he worked in physics. And soon after, around the time that I was born, in Kingston, around then, 1952, he moved down to the new Bell Telephone Laboratories, which was really a hotbed of creativity. A lot was happening there. The transistor had been invented, not yet, of course, but it was a place where a lot of very important inventions happened and a lot of very smart people happened and or were located. And there was a lot of discourse about all sorts of things, ideas going back and forth. Very, very important to have a place like that for a creative person like my father. While he was there, they worked on all sorts of things. I think he got 19 different patents, some of which are pretty well known, you know, continuously operating lasers as opposed to pulsed masers. But the really crowning piece was his invention of the charge-coupled device. The charge-coupled device basically is a solid-state gizmo that can take photons and turn them into signals that computers can process. It's really the heart of digital cameras, imaging devices of all sorts. My father retired not that long after that and came back to Wallace. And certainly he was very, very active after coming back to Wallace. He was involved in absolutely everything, ranging from helping to set up the community museum. He got involved with the local fisheries, where he made one of the first underwater cameras so that he could film lobsters down in lobster traps. That was done a long time ago. I think it's inevitable that my father's legacy is going to be for the charge couple device, which is what he won the Nobel Prize for. It was quite interesting. The very, very early CCDs, I think they had 16 pixels that they read. I think it's always important to recognize, you know, you get that proof of concept, and somebody might have said, oh, well, this isn't really very impressive. What a crummy technology. But other people would have picked up on it and would have said, wow, with a little bit of adaptation, we're going to be able to turn this into something that's going to put the old film, the silver film approaches and other photographic approaches, make them completely obsolete, which is indeed what happened. You'll notice it's very, very hard to find any film for your old cameras now. Been completely replaced by CCDs.